Good evening. I'm Kyle Webb, Reggie's youngest child. On behalf of the Webb family, we'd like to thank each and every one of you for showing your love and support. Please allow me a moment to share with you the life of a leader, a father, and a friend. Reggie was born in South Bend, Indiana, on March 25, 1948. In his early years, he frequently traveled to his Uncle Henry's farm in Madison, Arkansas. Having to go to the back of the bus at the Mason-Dixon line went a long way in shaping his views on leadership and making a positive difference in society. At 11 years old, he moved with his grandmother, Mama Annie, to Los Angeles. His mother and younger siblings soon followed. Reggie's work ethic was forged as he was a butler and doorman at many functions in West LA. Along with his family, Reggie attended Greater Ebenezer Baptist Church in South Central Los Angeles. Reggie attended Manual Arts High School, after which he enlisted in the United States Coast Guard and was stationed in Northern California. At the age of 18, he met who would become his life partner, Renee. They married 6 years later. Reggie and Renee had their first child, Kareem, in 1974, and their second child, Kiana, in 1978. At 25 years old, Reggie was hired by a rapidly growing company called McDonald's. Within months, he was promoted from store manager to supervisor to field consultant, helping franchisees maximize their restaurant's potential. Shortly thereafter, Reggie was relocated to McDonald's headquarters in Oak Brook, Illinois, where he was promoted to the National Director of Operations. In 1980, he was promoted to Regional Manager, which allowed him to move back to Southern California. Reggie served as a Regional Vice President of Los Angeles until December of 1985. At that time, he purchased his first two McDonald's franchises in Pomona, California. A few months prior, his third child, Kyle, was born. Upon becoming a franchisee, Reggie became active in the communities his stores serve and among his fellow franchisees. As the number of restaurants has grown to 12, Reggie's service-related positions have also grown. Reggie served as the chairman of the National Black McDonald's Owner Operators Association, NBMOA, from 1994 to 1998. During that time, he was credited with leading the NBMOA to reach a parity agreement with the McDonald's Corporation, which had a significantly positive impact on the McDonald's system. After Reggie's term as chairman of the NBMOA, he became chairman of the National Leadership Council, NLC, the organization that represents the McDonald's franchisees in the United States. Reggie became chairman of the NLC at a difficult time for McDonald's. He was an instrumental player, along with many others, in devising the strategy that has once again made McDonald's one of the world's strongest companies. As he was prepared to step down from his post at the NLC, the McDonald's community wouldn't let him go. They chose Reggie to be the first chairman of the Global Leadership Council, the organization that represents McDonald's franchisees worldwide. As in McDonald's, Reggie's contribution to the community in which he lives and does business has grown. He serves on the board of directors of the Pomona Valley Hospital and is the vice chairman of the Los Angeles County Fair. Reggie understands that the greater good is far better than anything produced by or for a single individual. As he always says, none of us is as good as all of us. Dad, I'd just like to thank you for the inspiration you've been to me, my brother, and my sister. And that inspiration has created a legacy, a last name in Webb. You have truly been the world's best father to each and every one of us. That means a lot to us. You mean a lot to us. So, Dad, this is your life, and we are truly grateful to be a part of it.